An electric drone with multiple rotors took its first flight in conventional air traffic near Paris on Thursday as it prepares for commercial flights from 2024. The Volocopter test aircraft, which resembles a large drone with 8 rotors, took off with a passenger on board from the Pontoise-Cormeilles airfield outside Paris and briefly circled around while other aircraft were in the vicinity. German company Volocopter CEO Dirk Hoch said that in the next 18 months it will prepare its craft for certification and said he hopes to launch short commercial flights by 2024 when Paris holds the Summer Olympic Games. The company wants its 2-seater aircraft to eventually take to the skies fully automated, with only passengers aboard, but admits that a lot of work was still needed in terms of infrastructure, airspace integration, and public acceptance. Test pilot Paul Stone said that the craft's digital fly-by-wire system and multiple rotors make it much easier to fly than a traditional helicopter. In this aircraft, they take away all that difficulty, and it's very simple controls in each axis. That's what makes it easier to fly, he said. Valerie Pécresse, president of the Île-de-France region around Paris, said the region had provided financial support for the initiative as she wants the first passenger flight in a vertical takeoff and landing aircraft to take place here. The development of low-altitude aviation for urban air mobility is an adventure full of promises, she said in a statement. Volocopter is in a costly race with companies around the world, including Lilium, Joby Aviation, Joby.in, and Airbus, AIR.PA, to have the first flying taxi certified by regulators. It is aiming to achieve this in around 2 years. Urban air mobility is a new form of sustainable aviation with a multitude of use cases that will provide regions and cities with an alternative form of transport for people and goods. Introducing a new form of mobility successfully requires industry-wide collaboration and the support of regulators and government bodies. The UAM ecosystem includes manufacturers of electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, EVTOL, physical and digital infrastructure providers, regulators, technology supply chain, cities, governments, the public, and many others. The fully integrated testbed at Pontoise-Cormeilles enables a variety of stakeholders to test technologies and procedures in diverse configurations in a real-life environment. The opportunity to test on a live airfield is both invaluable and essential to the development of the entire industry. The testbed at Pontoise-Cormeilles, designed by Skyports in collaboration with Group ADP, is aircraft agnostic and offers the entire ecosystem the chance to test and develop their technologies. Most importantly, it facilitates collaboration between the key ecosystem partners, including technology pioneers, regulators, and local partners such as the French Civil Aviation Authority, DGAC, suppliers, and airlines. It will enable the testing of vehicle integration, ground movement procedures, and charging procedures, flight scheduling, situational awareness, and information exchange, passenger journey through the terminal, including security and check-in processes, biometric technologies provided by CETA, passenger dwell time, and aircraft boarding. The launch event provided an opportunity to demonstrate the end-to-end passenger journey from arrival at the vertiport terminal to aircraft boarding. A model of the Volocity, which is being developed as Volocopter's first certified aircraft for commercial services, was featured at the launch in addition to a crewed test flight of the 2X model, the only aircraft currently authorized by DGAC for EVTOL test flights in France. The series of demonstrations by Skyports and Volocopter also featured displays of flight monitoring capabilities and digital operating systems, including Skyports vertiport operating systems and the Volo IQ. The reInvent air mobility testbed at Pontoise-Cormeilles airfield is now the most extensive technology-enabled test site for UAM in Europe. The innovation consortium is formed by Group ADP, Choose Paris Region, and RATP Group, and made up of 30 ecosystem partners. It has propelled France to the forefront of UAM development. The consortium focuses on a wide range of topics to facilitate the development of the industry, including vehicle development, vertiport infrastructure, airspace integration, and public acceptance. Augustin de Romanet, Group ADP Chairman and CEO, said, "In Pontoise-Cormeilles, we are taking a new decisive step in the development of electric air mobility. The passenger terminal marks the final stage in the development of the Pontoise testbed and the completion of a Volocopter flight fully integrated into the airfield's airspace is the epitome of a year of very ambitious test campaigns. We are now looking ahead to 2024, the development of all use cases, including health and logistics." Duncan Walker, CEO of Skyports, said, "The Pontoise-Cormeilles terminal is a physical demonstration of the fact that innovation won't occur in isolation. It requires collaboration from a multitude of area experts, including operators, vehicle manufacturers, and technology developers, each of which have an important role to play in achieving the ultimate objective of commercial AAM services. With the completion of the terminal, we will now begin comprehensive testing of procedures and technologies in a realistic aviation environment, creating a space for Skyports and consortium partners to accelerate the industry." Dirk Hoke, CEO of Volocopter, said, "Introducing a new kind of mobility like UAM can only be done successfully with a closely knit, yet open ecosystem. The testbed at Pontoise-Cormeilles is a stellar example of ecosystem partners collaborating to accelerate the realization of UAM. We can test processes, integrate new and old systems, and simulate different operational scenarios to create trust and positive awareness of all stakeholders. Together, we will succeed in providing an additional emission-free transport option for the public. Every test is one step closer to commercialization in time for 2024. Marie-Claude Dupuy, Strategy, Sustainable Development and Real Estate Director, RATP Group, said, "This year of testing and validation has enabled us to make progress in evaluating the acceptability of these new machines and the urban insertion of vertiports. We are working together on the next steps to test the new advanced air mobility by 2024. Valerie Pécresse, president of the Paris region, said, "The development of low-altitude aviation for urban air mobility is an adventure full of promises for employment, for the environment, and for the lives of Paris region residents. As the leading aeronautical region in France and Europe, Paris region has all the resources to be a pioneer in this field, and that is why we decided last year to support this exciting initiative financially. Just as the first plane ticket of the first airline company was purchased in 1914 in Florida, I want the first passenger flight in a vertical takeoff and landing aircraft to take place in our region, Paris region. The Olympics are an incredible opportunity to showcase and launch this project and promote the site's experimental facilities. We will continue to support this project while remaining vigilant to ensure that the inhabitants of Paris region benefit from it in compliance with our decarbonization objectives as detailed in the Regional Economic Strategy Impact 2028.